Yo,
what's up? This is Patrick.
This is Marco.
And in this video, I'm gonna explore with Marco, does size matter with your data model? Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Marco, I've been looking at model sizes and I'm trying to figure out, do they really matter? I'm looking at model sizes on my desktop. I'm looking at them in the service. I'm looking at it in the VPACS file, and I'm trying to get a grip on the size of those models, and I just can't figure it out. I just don't know which one is the right size, you know? And does it matter? And so I decided, let me reach out to my buddy Marco, because I'm sure he can break this down and help me get a handle on these model sizes.
What are the numbers that are getting you confused?
Oh, so if I start in the desktop, wait. Enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do. Let's head over to my laptop. If I look right here at my PBIX file, let me do a quick right click so you can see what the size of this guy is. So it's 276 megs. And then I head out to the service. If I click right here and choose manage storage when I'm in the workspace that contains this model, I can see it's pretty consistent. But then if I go out to DAC Studio, DAC Studio 3, by the way, and I look at my VPACS file, it's 404 megs. I'm so confused.
I can show you how this work by explaining step by step which sizes are for different objects. What is the meaning of those numbers? Let's start with the file that you had at the beginning, this PBIX file on your machine. And the size of this file was 276 megabytes. Now, within the PBIX file, we actually have everything, the report, and we have the data model. Now, the data model is stored within the file, and it is technically a backup of the model that you have in memory. We don't see that. We don't know the size of that, but it's within that 276 megabytes. Now, when you publish the model, this file is sent to the service, and this is expanded to a bigger thing, which is the size that we have in memory. But in reality, the size that you see is basically the same size of the PBX file. So they are actually the same size. However, this backup file that we can imagine is here is then expanded in memory in the analysis services process, where we have what is called the VertiPack engine. Now, the VertiPack engine has the same amount of data, but in memory, it takes more space because the format of the backup file that we had in the PBX file is an additional compression over the compression of the data that you have in memory, because part of the data in VertiPack is not compressed, like the dictionary, for example. So it's normal that this size is bigger. It could be the 404 megabytes that you see in DAC Studio. But in reality, when you have a client like, you know, your browser, and you draw the chart, the table, and so on, all this stuff that you have in the page in the Power BI are sending DAX queries to analysis services. But analysis services has additional memory for the connection, for other additional elements, like, for example, the report cache that you have for the connection for the browser. And this takes memory.
I think I'm starting to get a grasp of this, right? But is there a way that we could simulate this in the desktop where I can see, okay, here's my report. I click to another page. I see this memory consumption happening. Is there any tools or anything I can do to do that?
Absolutely. What you have on the service is exactly what you have on the desktop. But we can understand what is happening on the service by just looking at the processes that run on your machine using just Task Manager, for example.
All right, so enough of all this talking, Marco. I think we need to head back to my laptop. Here's Patrick's big data model, the one that I'm trying to, you know, get a grip on. You can see I have these four pages at the bottom. So should I just switch to a new page?
Yes, all but right. Before you do this, let me explain what we have now. In Task Manager, the Power BI desktop process is actually running several processes. The single line that is highlighted now is the Microsoft SQL Server Analysis Services process, which has the DAX engine, the VertiPack engine, and your data model. All the other processes are there just to render the visualization. What matters for the analysis of the dataset is just what we have in the SQL Server Analysis Services. At this point, the only memory we're consuming is the memory of the VertiPack database that is loaded in memory, plus the additional memory that analysis services has to allocate to keep the connection open and something else. So far, you didn't query anything, so there are no additional, let's say, caches that has been consumed by analysis services to store the intermediate version of the data that is sent back to Power BI.
All right, but now I want to make some of those happen, right? So I'm going to switch over here to this page. That was pretty fast.
Yes.
Let's see, my memory, yes. It didn't take up much.
Exactly. Not only the memory didn't take much, but you didn't even consume much CPU. So you see that there is a percentage of the CPU that was a 0%, that it went up to 1, 2%. But it never went up to 25%.
So now I'm gonna switch to another page. And this is a page that my report consumers are complaining about a bit. Very similar to the other page. I just have a different measure that I'm using, Marco. And you can see there's a little spinny.
Not only you have seen this spinning, but you have seen that the memory increased and you had a lot of CPU consumption. The model is the same, but the measure that you used created a large temporary table in memory, and these temporary tables are uncompressed. This is the reason why it is a multiple of the initial size of the model, because the model compresses one size that we have seen 200, 300, 400 megabytes, but now you consume more than 2, almost 3 gigabytes at a certain point, just because the memory was uncompressed in memory for millions of rows. Probably the largest table of this model you told me before is 10 million rows. To multiply by, you know, a few kilobytes for each row, if the model is large, it's insane. It takes a lot of RAM.
Focus on the CPU and the memory columns. I'm gonna switch over to page 4, and everybody's complaining about this page also, Marco. CPU's going up, memory's going up. I need to do something here.
Once again, we probably have a DAX measure that is doing something that is not a good practice and is consuming too much RAM compared to the result, because at the end of the day, you have to display a few numbers, so you just have to find a way to write in DAX code that doesn't have to allocate too much memory. But the goal today is to understand what is going on, and so the largest amount of memory that you had in analysis services, now on your desktop, is memory to keep temporary tables, basically. And this is the same behavior that happens in the cloud. So if you publish this report in the cloud, your browser doesn't consume memory, but the memory of analysis services is consumed on the server. And the server doesn't serve only one user, you, but it serves multiple users. So you can see that the memory grows on the service because people use reports with measures that allocate temporary table. Sometimes it is not DAX, but in this case, I'm pretty sure that it's something related to the DAX code.
This is really helping me understand what's going on with my premium capacity metrics app. And I'm gonna show you that in a bit, but the DAX that we wrote was intentional, everyone. So you can see there's a measure called sales amount slow. If you go back and watch, it was a very intentional thing to make this happen. So Marco, now I think I understand what's going on, but let me show you what I have here. I published my report out and I set up the premium capacity metrics app, and then we'll go over to it. So you can see my data set here. And you remember, we talked about the file on disk, 277 megs, the file in storage, yep, 277 megs. I think I understand why it's so big, but why, when I right click here and I drill through to artifact detail, when I initially loaded this guy up, it was 0.46, and this almost goes exactly with the size I saw of the VPACS file when I initially loaded this up. But then, yep, people start using my report, the size went up to 2 gigs, then it looks like it went down again to 0.46, then it went back up to 1.62. It's like a roller coaster, man. I'm not at a theme park or anything. I just need some consistency here. Can you explain this to me?
Likely, yes, because what is happening is the following. First of all, you will not see the same behavior on your desktop, because analysis services is built in a way that once it allocates memory, it doesn't release it unless something happens. So your dataset stays in memory only if it is used by other users or by yourself. But if it is not used for a while and the service has to serve other users, so it is removed from the memory so that there is memory available for other services. When the user click on the report, however, that database has to be restored in memory. And as soon as the user uses another bad measure, the memory size increases, as you have seen after a few hours.
Wow. All right. So I'm going to be honest with you. I think I finally have a grip on the size of my models. All right, Marco, thank you so much for joining us. I hope everybody enjoyed this as much as I have. I'm definitely gonna use this and talk about this, you know, going forward. You guys know what to do though. If you have any questions, comments, post them in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam
and Marco
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.